Many people think that speed and velocity is same, but it is not. Speed is scalar and the velocity is vector. Average speed of a moving object is always positive, but the average velocity can be positive, negative, or even zero. Stay with me and learn the concepts of speed and velocity in most easy and interactive way.
What is speed? Speed is distance covered per unit time. It tells us how fast or slow an object is moving. So what we need to know to find out the speed? Let's consider this car. Car is traveling from O to destination A. As per definition of speed, speed is distance covered per unit time. That means, to find out the speed, we need two physical quantities. Distance traveled, here in this case you can take a small d, and the time taken to cover this distance, t. Mathematically, if we want to represent the speed, we can say it's a d by t. Now, what is velocity? Velocity is the displacement of an object from its reference point or starting point per unit time. Here, capital U represents the velocity, which is equal to capital D by T. Capital D is displacement. In this particular case, when motion is in a straight line and a single direction, displacement is same as a distance. Velocity is a vector quantity. So, capital D by T represents its magnitude. We need a direction as well. So, we can say the velocity of car is capital D by T in the direction of OA. Now, for the student who don't know about the difference between distance and displacement, here is a 40 seconds clip from our previous video. Let's watch it. In this case, you see there is a car at point O, which is a reference point, and it will travel to point A through this curvy path. Now, the distance traveled by this car is the actual measurement of this path which is followed by the car. Let's take 50 meters. But if we talk about the displacement, then it is a minimum distance between this point O and A, and that is calculated or that is represented by a straight line connecting these two points. What is average speed or average velocity? What about instantaneous speed or instantaneous velocity? How you find the constant speed or constant velocity? Or what about uniform or non-uniform linear motion? To understand the concepts behind all these, let's take an example. Here is an example of car moving, and we'll try to find out the average speed and velocity. So in this example, the car is moving from origin point O to A, and it covers 54 km to reach the destination A. And this travel, it completes in 1.5 hours. Now to find out the average speed is nothing but your total distance covered divided by total time. So this will be, if I represent by a small u, so u1 will be your total distance is 54 and divided by total time, it will be 36 km per hour, right? Now if I talk about the average velocity is your total displacement covered divided by total time. Now total displacement is my final position of the car minus my initial position. My final position of car is at 54 km from my starting point or my reference point. So if I represent capital U1 for this velocity, my displacement difference is 54 minus 0 divided by total time, consume. So it's again 36 km per hour, right? This is a magnitude of my velocity and direction is my plus x direction, right? In OA direction. Now when we finding the average speed or average velocity, we just concerned about the total distance or total displacement. We are not bothered about how the travel was done. Did the car stop on the way? Did the car speed decreased or increased for frequent time intervals? Those type of information we can define by using other motion parameters like instantaneous speed or velocity, uniform or non-uniform motions. To know about these parameters, we have divided this 54 km motion in three different segments. In the first part of the motion, it covers 18 km in 0.5 hour. That means the average speed during this segment is 18 divided by 0.5 and this will be equal to 36 km per hour. Now for the second part of the motion, it again covers 18 km in half an hour. So my speed remains same, which is 36 km per hour. And then in the last part of the motion, it covers another 18 km and consume 0.5 hours. Okay, so my speed again in this segment come out to be 36 km per hour. So the motion where you have equal interval of time and you find the distance traveled by the object remains same, like in this case 18 km every half an hour, so it remains same. That type of motion is known as your constant speed or uniform speed motion, where you have equal distance in equal interval of time. Now what about instantaneous speed? Instantaneous speed, as name suggested, it's for some particular instant of time. Okay, what does that mean? For example, during this motion, if I want to find the speed of the car at the moment of 10 minutes after starting of this motion. So at that moment, what is the speed of the car? It might be 20 km per hour or it may be 40 km per hour. Okay, so that moment of time, what is the speed of the car, that is known as your instantaneous speed. Okay, now if we talk about the velocity for the same purpose, right, what is constant velocity? The constant velocity, it means object cover the same distance in equal interval of time in a particular direction. So what I did, I just added the direction with your constant speed. So if my direction remains constant, that means I am traveling in a straight line, right? I am not changing my direction. So constant velocity basically means your straight line motion in a same direction with the constant speed. Okay, so in other words, I can say constant velocity is nothing but your uniform motion. Uniform motion, what you need? You need a straight line motion with constant speed and constant direction. Okay, so both are same thing. If you see properly, you see the constant velocity, which means the constant speed plus constant direction, is same thing as a uniform motion. So that we can achieve, this constant speed and constant direction we can achieve only in a straight line motion. Okay, you understand this part. This straight line motion is important, right? Without that, you cannot get a constant velocity. So it can happen only in case of a straight line motion. So that type of motion is known as uniform linear motion. Okay, more specifically, we can say uniform linear motion. Why I say linear motion? Because we are talking about here the linear velocity, right? If we talk about uniform circular motion, then the definition will change with the your circular or your rotational parameters. Like instead of linear velocity, it will be your rotational velocity. Okay, so there is a difference. If you have any doubt, you can always put comment in comment box and I can answer to you in details. Now what about non-uniform motion? Okay, non-uniform motion means if you don't follow the rules of uniform motion. What are the rules for uniform motion? Rules for uniform motions are, your motion should be in a straight line, and it should be with constant speed, and it should be with constant direction, right? So if any of these parameters or any of these conditions doesn't meet in your motion, then your motion will be non-uniform motion. Now, I have one question for you. You have seen there is a speedometer in the car. What this speedometer shows to you? Is it your average speed or instantaneous speed, or is average velocity or instantaneous velocity? Okay, think about it and answer it. Yes, you are right. And this speedometer shows the instantaneous speed of the vehicle. Now, let's go for finding out the average speed and average velocity for car travel in different scenarios. So now let's go back to our initial setup, where car traveled from O to A 54 km. Now this car take a turn, okay, U-turn, and is moving now towards B, means it's moving towards its origin point from where it started O. So it moves from A to B 36 km in 1 hour. So what is the speed during this period? During this period, the average speed is 36 km per hour, right? What about my velocity? If I represent the velocity is a capital U2, this will be my final displacement with initial displacement with respect to my starting point O, right? Because we're talking about everything with respect to starting point O here. So my final displacement is OB, because my car is presently at point B, which is nothing but 18 km, because 54 minus 36 is 18 km, minus the OA, initial displacement, which is nothing but 54, divided by time taken, 1. So it will be minus 36 km per hour. That means my velocity during this period is minus 36 km per hour. Magnitude is same as my speed, but minus is representing your direction. Direction is in your minus x direction, okay? Now let's check the car further move from B to its original point in 0.5 hour. Again, this here the direction is negative x direction. So my average speed during this period is 18 divided by 0.5, so again 36 km per hour, right? And if I want to say the capital U3, which is a velocity during this period, is my final displacement is 0, my initial displacement, which is OB, is 18, so divided by 0.5, so again this will be minus 36 km per hour, okay? It means my velocity is 36 km per hour in minus x direction or negative direction. Now let's see car move from O to another point, which is 54 km in my minus x direction, and it covers it in 1.5 hours. So here the average speed of this travel, which is U4, and it can be 54 divided by 1.5. And again, it's a 36 km per hour, right? Velocity, if I talk about, which is capital U4, final displacement is minus 54, right? Here, you see, this is a minus 54, right? If I start with this origin and go in negative direction. So, minus 54 minus 0, right? Divided by how much time? 1.5. So, it will become minus 36 km. Per hour. So now you see, during whole this process, when the car start traveling from point A and going B, O, and reaching to this point, let's take this point is C, okay, in this whole process my velocity is negative, you see, negative 36 km per hour. It says that from A to C is a continuously single direction, which is minus x direction, and with the constant speed of 36 km per hour. Average speed during this period is 36, 36, and 36. all are positive. Because speed is always positive. Reason, because speed is a distance traveled by time. And distance is always positive. It cannot be negative, right? Because distance is a scalar quantity. Similarly, the speed is a scalar quantity. So speed is always positive. Right, now let's see the car move back to its origin point, but with a higher speed. It covered that 54 kilometer only in 0.5 hours. So what is my average speed during this period? This is represented by U5, and this will be 54 divided by 0.5 hours. So it's a 108 kilometer per hour, right? And if I talk about the velocity, capital U5, my final displacement is 0 because it reached to my origin point. My initial displacement is minus and minus 54, right, divided by 0.5. So minus minus plus, so it is plus 108 kilometer per hour. So here you see this is a plus direction, means because it's moving into positive x direction. Right, so during this period my average speed is 108 kilometer per hour, which is far more than whatever we saw in first three or four segment of motion. In this first segment also we saw the average speed was 36 kilometer per hour, right? So now let's calculate the average speed for this complete travel. The average speed is nothing but the total distance covered divided by total time, right? So if I say average speed is u, okay, will be equal to the total distance. Now how we find out the total distance? We have to check from start of this motion from point O, car travel 54 kilometer and reach to A. So you take 54 kilometer. Then from A to B, 36 kilometer. So this is 30. Then from B to O, it reached 18 kilometer. And then it moved from O to point C. It's another 54 kilometer. And then it came back to point O again by traveling this 54 kilometer, right? So it's 54 kilometer. So here you see the distance travel, we are not bothering about plus and minus sign, because plus and minus sign only comes when we talk about the position of the car, and that is required in case of displacement, not in case of distance. So total distance is sum of these distances traveled. Now it is divided by total time. Total time is here in the first 54 kilometer travel 1.5, and then for another 36 kilometer it traveled for 1 hour. This is 1.5 hour, 1 hour. And then in third segment of motion, it's traveled for 0.5 hour. Here it traveled for 1.5 hour. And here it traveled for 0.5 hour. So total is, if you add these up, it will come out as a 5 hours. Okay, so this is total 5 hours. If you solve this, it becomes like total of these 5 travels is 216 kilometer, right? 216 kilometer. And divided by 5, right? So if I divide this, this become 43.2 kilometer per hour, right? So that is what my average speed for this travel. Now, if I want to know the average velocity, which is capital U, for this travel, this complete travel. So, what I need to know? I need to know the displacement, the total displacement at the end of this travel. Now, car started from origin O and it came back to the same point, right? So, displacement is 0, right? Because your initial and final position is same. So that's why displacement is 0. And total time taken is 5 hours. So this becomes 0 kilometer per hour. That is what your average velocity. Now it is a time for 3 conceptual questions from today's topic. Try these questions and put your answers in comment box. To check the answers, you can go in our description box. I hope you would have enjoyed this session. If you think you have learned something new today, then please click like button and subscribe us for similar type of videos. In our next video, you will be learning how to draw a displacement time graph for a series of motions and how to use this graph to find out different motion parameters. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.